Good morning, class 5. How are you guys doing? I hope you all are doing great and fine. So today we are on, without wasting time, we are on your English course book, class 4. Okay, so sorry, I just said 5. So this is class 4. We are on unit 4, page 48. The story is The Days of the Banyan Tree. This story has been taken, it's an excerpt from The Seasons of Splendor by Madhur Jaffrey. So Madhur Jaffrey, born 1933, is an award-winning actress who is also a writer. She also does theatre and has appeared in several British TV series. She is most famous, however, for being best-selling cookery book about cooking. A writer and has written several cookbooks that simplify Indian cooking, especially curries and kebabs. So Madhur Jaffrey is very well known. There are some few movies also in which she has acted. So he has an autobiography, you know, a story of written by someone about their own life, about Madhur Jaffrey, about her childhood life in India. So there was an old banyan tree. Now what is a banyan tree? Banyan tree is basically in our, it's a very sacred tree. Of many cultures to worship around the trees and their surroundings, then has been given sacred meanings, their birth, growth, death, elasticity of their branches. It's a very sacred tree. It's a very holy tree, the banyan tree. Now in many cultures also the banyan tree is known for its bargat. It's known as the vat. Or Bargat tree is amongst the venerated trees in India. For centuries it has been likened to shelter that God provides for his devotees. You know, people sit under the banyan tree, they get a lot of shade, the air is very good, beautiful leaves, it's like a temple type of leaf. There on the banyan Bargat leaves, many things are written also in the Puranas in the early days also. So it's a holy tree, as far as we know. Okay, so we'll keep it till there. There was an old banyan tree that grew just outside our house in India. She's in India right now. It was more than a tree, it seemed to be a whole forest. You know, banyan trees are huge, their roots also hang from the tree all by itself. Its trunk went up, up and up, almost 100 feet. It must have been a huge tree. Some of the branches, instead of rising and spreading like outstretched arms, you know, like spreading their arms, made nose dives toward the earth, where they burrowed in and took root and reappeared as fresh trunks. My nanny, or Aya, who used to look after her, as we called her, said that the roots of a banyan tree went all the way to the underworld, and that when they rose again as fresh trunks, they carried up with them all sorts of ghosts and goblins. Goblins are small dwarfs, you know, it's all myths, stories people say. So the branches don't grow, spread, some branches spread like that, some again come down and go into the earth, become straight as trunks, again they grow roots from there, again they grow roots, again another trunk comes out from there. So it's a huge kind of tree. You can see the picture also, you must have seen a Barkat tree. She insisted that there never was a banyan tree without a few ghosts lurking in its branches. And Aya is telling her that always there is something in those trees, some bhoot or some ghost or something is there in it. My grandmother, on the other hand, said that the banyan tree was a blessed tree because it had the wisdom of its years and because it provided so much shade. But her grandmother, Madhu's grandmother, used to tell her that it's not like that. You know, we have a lot of stories about it, gives a lot of shade and a lot of good things happen under that tree. And lot of wisdom of its years, because it's so old. In fact, in the burning months of May and June, we prayed to it and offered it the best of the summer's yield, seedless cucumbers, watermelons, aubergines and mangoes. Aubergines are eggplants, bagan. So during the May and June hot summers, they used to pray to the tree that so that we should have some good vegetables during this time. We should have seedless cucumbers, we should have watermelons, aubergines and mangoes also. In fact, in the burning months, they prayed to that tree so that we get is to pray and offer fruits and watermelons and cucumbers to this tree, you know, for a good yield, for the good agriculture should happen. I saw grandmother's point. In the summer, scorching winds blasted in from the neighboring deserts, carrying with them particles of sand to irritate eyes and parch throats. Parch throat means your throat becomes dry in the summer. Those hot blue wind blows and dust comes and hits your eyes. Also, sometimes the sand also comes in and hits your eyes. When the sky overhead felt like an oven with its door left open by some careless cook, the banyan trees offered cool, natural arbors to perspiring travelers. So when the sky at that time is so hot, you know, it's like an oven, you know, it's the door is open and now heat is coming in, like some cook has forgotten to close the oven and the heat is coming down. And at that time, this tree gives total shade and cool. And to those people who are sweating, perspiration is sweating, you know, perspirizing people are sweating and also they sit under that tree and get that coolness. So God gives them that shade to rest and take and feel peace. My grandmother always advised me, on your way back from school, remember to get off your bicycle and rest under the shade of the banyan tree. Rest under the banyan tree and bump into a ghost. Oh dear me, no, I paid no attention to my grandmother. In fact, when I reached the banyan trees, I held my breath and bicycled for my life. No ghosts were going to catch me. Because the ayah told her that remember that when something comes in that there are a lot of ghosts also in the branches, be careful. And the grandmother saying, when you remember while coming back from school, you must sit under the tree in the shade and take some rest, you know, wisdom comes from it. But she is saying, oh my God, no, when getting entangled with a ghost and I'll go and hit some ghost or something. No, when I cross that tree, I just simply pedal and go out. I held my breath and bicycled for my life. Quickly, let's go out from there. No ghosts were going to catch me. Excuse me. So this is the story all about. A small little bit story. So we'll go to the next page and I'll come back in the next video also. Okay.